It's common for casinos to forget clocks and windows, so patrons will forget about how much time is spent at the slots. But go to the back half of KCK's new Hollywood Casino, and it is sheets of glass, overlooking Kansas's equivalent to oceanfront property, turn two at the Kansas Speedway.
It's a fantastic view here every day, but especially race day, just to see thousands of people out throughout the facility as the race cars come around the turn. It's just a fabulous, exciting experience.
At every turn, its design is meant to excite the visitor. The architecture, the lights, the technology.
And then we've got these glass panels going in where we'll actually project the video screens of the games right onto the glass panels.
It's got decadent glass walls, murals, and a video ribbon board displaying its theme, 1930s glitz and glamour of old Hollywood.
You're going to feel like you're in Vegas.
It's really, if you look at the facility, the design is really all about a very contemporary Las Vegas style casino.
All of this makes the riverboat casinos in Missouri do as all good gamers do. When you get nervous, you put on a good poker face.
I wish them the best of the success to the west, and I'll take the best of the success to the east.
Both Ameristar and Hollywood anticipate about 3 million area visitors next year. But are there really enough people interested to visit both? Or will Hollywood, next to some of Kansas's biggest tourist attractions, bring in enough new tourists to really expand the market?
We're going to take some business from the other competitors in the market, but I think we're going to add some new business to the market as well. I think it'll be overall healthy for the overall economy.
A prediction casinos on both sides of the state line hope is in a roll of the dice with their future.